हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम। टुडे इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर पीरियड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर 6, एडवर्ब्स। पार्ट 1 आई एम गोइंग टू कवर टुडे चिल्ड्रेन। सो यू आर गोइंग टू ओपन योर ग्रामर टेक्स्ट बुक क्विकली। सी पेज नंबर 41। ओपन्ड, ग्रेट। हियर चिल्ड्रेन, यू कैन सी एट द टॉप ऑफ द पेज three pictures are given and the question written there is, read the following sentences, note the underlined words. As usual, we are going to observe the picture carefully, we are going to read the sentence written below the picture, and by reading the sentence you are going to give attention to the underlined words, and some words are circled also, so we are going to give attention to that words which are circled and underlined. Okay, see the first picture children and read the sentence written below. Meena looks miserable. Second picture and the sentence written is, Hari speaks softly. And the third picture is about the players. They are playing football, right? So our team played well. So in this above sentences children, you can see that the circled words are, which are the circled word? Yes, miserable, softly, and then well. So these underlined words are adverbs. Why do we call them as adverb? Because they add meaning to the verbs. Add verbs. Like how we learn that adjective add meanings to the nouns. Same way, adverbs add meanings to the verbs. And these adverbs are called the adverbs of manner. Which adverbs? Miserable, softly, well. These adverbs are called as adverb of manners. Why are they called as adverb of manners? Because they tell how an action occurs. For example, when we ask questions, how does Meena look? So we answer with the help of picture, Meena looks miserable. So the answer tells us, excuse me, the answer tells us about the verb. How does Meena look? Meena looks miserable. How does Hari speak? Hari speaks softly. And how does our team play? Our team played well. So we get the answers miserable, softly, and well by asking these questions, and that's why they are called as adverbs of manner. Understood, children? So let's check whether we understood or not by solving this very simple activity. Activity A. The boys were talking excitedly. The boys were talking excitedly. Just now we learned that if you are getting the answer by asking the question how, whichever answer you will get, that is the adverb of manner. So the boys were talking excitedly. Then, yes, the word excitedly is the adverb of manner, because we can get this answer by asking the question, how the boys were talking, isn't it? Let's move ahead quickly and read the second question. It's very interesting and easy. We walked fast. Which is the adverb? Adverb of manner. He walked fast. How did he walk? He walked fast. So, fast is the adverb of manner. He was treated shamefully. How was he treated? Shamefully. So, shamefully is the answer. Sita laughed happily. How did Sita laugh? Sita laughed happily. So, happily is the answer. Suzanne asked the man his name politely. Very good. You have already picked out all the adverb of manners from the questions. Very good. Politely is the answer. Suzanne asked the man his name politely. राम विल वर्क हार्ड टू पास द एग्जामिनेशन. राम विल वर्क हार्ड टू पास द एग्जामिनेशन. नाउ विच इज द एडवर्ब ऑफ मैनर? यस, द वर्ड हार्ड इज द एडवर्ब ऑफ मैनर. इजी, गुड. लेट्स मूव अहेड एंड लर्न द अनादर टाइप ऑफ एडवर्ब. Now we are going to read these sentences. You two, read it aloud with me. Nitin comes to school regularly. The match began very early. I bought a sari yesterday. Now in these sentences, the words regularly, early, yesterday, these are the underlined words and they are adverbs. Why? Because they tell us something about the verbs. Now, which are the verbs in these sentences? In these sentences, the verbs are comes, then began and bought. These are the verbs. And these underlined words are telling us more about these words. Isn't it? So, that is why they are called as adverbs of time. So our next type of adverb is adverb of time, because the words which tell us when an action occurs are called adverbs of time. When we ask the question, when does Nitin come to school, we get the answer regularly. When does Nitin come to school? Nitin comes to school regularly. Remember children, it's very easy to understand when we ask the question by how and you are getting the answer. That is adverb of manner, usually. Now, here for adverb of time, we are asking the question by when. The match began very early. When does the match begin? The match began early. I bought a sari yesterday. When did I buy a sari? Yesterday. So, when I ask the question by when, whatever answers we are getting, these all words are adverbs of time. Easy? Now, let's solve one activity based on this. Pick out the verb adverb of time. All the garbage was not here yesterday. All the garbage was not here yesterday. So which is the adverb of time here? Great. Yesterday is the adverb of time. The bird visited us often. Often is the adverb of time. How did the bird visit? The bird visited us often. I will leave tomorrow. So when will you leave? I will leave tomorrow. So tomorrow is the adverb of time. Tina drinks milk daily. Very good. Answer daily is the answer. Then Sheetal will go to the market later. Sheetal will go to the market later. Which is the answer? Yes, later. Alice arrived at my house early. When did Alice arrive at my house? Early. So, early is the adverb of time. Let's move ahead and learn another type of adverb. And that is, for that, we have to read these sentences, and by reading, you have to be careful to see which words are underlined and you have to note it down. I will stay here with all my friends. I couldn't find my car keys anywhere. The children had scattered their toys everywhere. Now, the words which tell where the action occurs are called as adverb of place, because the underlined words here, anywhere, everywhere, these are the adverbs. because they are adding the meaning of the verbs. Which are the verbs in this sentences? The verbs are stay in the first sentence, stay. In the second sentence, which is the verb? Find. The word anywhere is adding meaning to the verb find. I couldn't find my car keys anywhere. And in the third sentence, which is the verb? The children had scattered their toys everywhere. Scattered. So the word everywhere is adding meaning to the verb scattered. So here anywhere and everywhere, these are the adverbs because they are adding meaning to the verb stay, find and scattered. The words which tell where the action occurs are called as adverbs of place. Remember, where the action occurs, that adverbs are called as adverbs of place. Especially when we ask the question. Now see, first question, where will we stay? I will stay with all my friends. Where couldn't I find my car keys? I couldn't find my car keys anywhere. Where had the children scattered their toys? The children had scattered their toys everywhere. So, after asking these questions, we are getting the answers here, anywhere and everywhere. So, these words are called as adverbs of place. Easy? Let's solve the activity given below this. Excuse me. Question C is pick out the adverbs of place. Now, five questions are given and just now we learned what are the adverbs of place. Let's read the first sentence. My uncle has come back. Children, in the book, home is also written here. Isn't it? So that home we have to cancel. It should not be there. Okay, so just put a cross over there and give full stop after back. So pick out the adverbs of place. My uncle has come back. Now what we learned, how to identify the adverb of place by asking the question, where? Where has my uncle come? My uncle has come back. So adverb of place is back. So back is the word we have to underline. The children went ahead. And which is the adverb of place? Head. I looked for my watch everywhere. Where did I look for my watch? Everywhere. So everywhere is the adverb of place. Fourth sentence. He was standing outside. Where was he standing? Outside. So underline outside. It's the adverb of place. The boys ran away. And the adverb of place is away. Underline that word. Easy? Okay. So this way, children, we have come to an end of today's session. We have learned that the word which adds meaning to the verb are called as adverbs. And today we have learned three kinds of adverbs. Adverb of manner, adverb of time and adverb of place. And with the help of the activities given, we practiced it. So let's stop here, children. Sai Ram.